Today I'm going to show you a horror film called Veronica. Spoilers ahead. Watch out and take care. The day is June 15, 1991. Heavy rain takes over the city of Madrid. Police cars receive a call from a girl asking for help. She keeps saying, "He's inside. He's inside." As the police arrive at the apartment, they sense something unnatural and are completely in shock as they see what's behind the door. 3 days before the incident happened, Veronica's family has a simple life. She has three younger siblings, Lucia, Irene, who are twins, and Antonito. She is in charge of feeding them, getting them ready for school, and everything in between. She mainly takes care of them because their mother has to work long hours to make ends meet after the recent death of their father. Veronica goes inside her parents' room to find pictures of her father, whom she misses very much. She finds one and decides to bring the picture to school. Veronica goes to a Catholic school, and nuns run it. In the classroom, the teacher talks about the phenomenon of a solar eclipse that also happens to occur on that day. The teacher explains that in some cultures, they believe that darkness takes over the world when the eclipse happens. She also says that ancient people use that day to perform human sacrifices and to summon dark spirits. The faculty gather the students on the school rooftop to watch and take a glimpse of the rare solar eclipse. Instead of joining the other students in viewing the phenomenon, Veronica, her friend Rosa, and their classmate Diana head to the school basement to perform a séance. The basement is dark, dusty, and run down, but it did not stop the three of them to go down there. Meanwhile, the rest of the students are excited to catch a sight of the eclipse. They all hold a negative film strip to protect their eyes from the harmful sunlight. Veronica and her friends continue the séance using an Ouija board. They all want to contact a loved one who has died. They close their eyes, touch the glass on the board, and try to contact spirits. The glass moves and the three of them start to get scared. They ask the spirit for its name, and if it wants to communicate, it responds by moving the glass. Rosa and Diana remove their hand from the glass, leaving Veronica the only one touching it. The glass moves around the board rapidly and leaves them all shocked. Rosa and Diana place their hands on the glass again and try to ask for the spirit's name. Once more, the glass moves rapidly and becomes too hot to touch, leaving Veronica the only one touching it again. The eclipse happens, and Veronica sits still while holding the glass as it eventually breaks, giving her a bloody index finger. Rosa and Diana start to worry about Veronica because she stays still. The candle's lights go out, and they struggle to find their flashlights. Veronica is lying unconscious, but she is murmuring words until she lets out a demonic scream. She blacks out and ends up at the school clinic. The resident doctor at the school asks her questions to know why she fainted. Without any apparent reason, the doctor advises her to rest. As she meets up with her two sisters after class, they notice the school's headmistress, an elderly blind woman who everyone calls Sister Death, looking directly at Veronica as if she can see. As they arrive home, Veronica goes straight to her room to observe the Ouija board that cut in half after their séance. She carefully puts her backpack with the board on top of her closet. She goes outside but hears a noise from her room. As she re-enters, the bag is on the floor. She places it on top of the closet once again. The same thing happens, her bag is on the floor. This is the beginning of the paranormal experiences that Veronica will encounter. While having dinner, Veronica starts shaking and is unable to put the food in her mouth. Her younger siblings begin to get scared and worry about her. Veronica snaps out of it. Still confused, she says that she is completely fine. She notices claw and bite marks appear on her body as well. After having so many questions in her mind, she tries calling Rosa, but it seems like her friend is avoiding her. While bathing Antonito, Veronica hears a thumping sound from the living room. She tells Lucia and Irene to behave and keep quiet, but both are in their rooms. The light in her room starts flickering, and she is locked inside. Antonito screams for Veronica from the bathroom because the water in the bath turned extremely hot, leaving the poor boy with burns. Veronica cleans up for the night as she notices the TV suddenly turning on, and Antonito's reflection is seen from the TV as she turns it off, directly looking at her from behind. In the middle of the night, her closet mirror opens out of nowhere. Someone calls her, and she sees an entity that exactly looks like her father. She panics as it drags her back to the bed and entangles her. She realizes that it is just a nightmare even though it seems too realistic to be a dream. Veronica's friends begin to ignore her. Looking for answers, she goes back to the basement alone, where Sister Death already awaits her. The nun warns her about the situation that she is in and continues to scold her for trying to summon someone from the dead. Sister Death tells Veronica that her siblings are in danger and that she must protect them. The nun attempts to propel the spirit to leave the girl alone, but it is not compelling enough. Veronica confronts Rosa about why she avoids her, but she denies that what happened in the basement isn't real. At home, she draws protective symbols for her siblings. Her sister contacts her from the walkie-talkie. From across their room, Veronica sees the spirit, and she runs as fast as she can to rescue her sisters. The spirit chokes Lucia, but she wakes up and claims that it was Veronica who choked her. That same night, Veronica has a dream that her siblings are devouring her flesh. She shouts for help, but once again, it is just a dream. She woke up to having her first period, finally reaching womanhood. She scrubs the blood on her bed, and as she turns it upside down, burn marks are present. She checks her siblings' mattresses, and the same burn marks are also present in the form of a human body. To seek advice, Veronica goes to Sister Death. The nun reveals to her that she intentionally blinded herself in an attempt to stop visions of evil spirits. She is unsuccessful because even without her vision, she can still feel and sense dark entities. Sister Death reminds Veronica that the spirit summoned has to go back through the same door she opened. It is crucial that Veronica has to bid farewell to the same spirit to stop it from being in her life and destroy the door open during the seance. Veronica comes over to Rosa's house. There is a party going on, and she persuades Rosa to bid goodbye to the spirit that they summoned. She looks for Diana at the house, also forcing her to finish the seance officially. She is kicked out of the party, and Rosa does nothing to help her. Rosa reveals to her that Veronica whispered that she would die in 3 days. Feeling terrified and alone, Veronica walks home with a troubled mind as her vision becomes phased. She reaches their bar and desperately asks her mom to stay at home with them for the night. Her mom explains that she is busy and cannot afford to close the bar for a night. Veronica and her siblings head home, and she decides to continue the seance at their apartment. She comes up with the idea to do it with her younger siblings. It confuses them as they are still young, but they obey their older sister's commands anyway. Antonito draws the protective signs around their apartment. He flips to the wrong page and draws the symbol of invocation instead, inviting the evil spirit even more. Ready to hold the seance, except for Antonito, all of them touch the glass on the Ouija board. They command the spirit to say goodbye, but it refuses. The book instructs that they have to sing a soft song to properly say goodbye to the spirit disturbing them. All of them sing in unison. They begin to hear thumping noises around their apartment. The spirit attempts to distract and scare them. The candle's lights go out, the Ouija board tears apart in half, and the glass moves around the apartment. Veronica follows it fearfully and ends up in the bedroom. The spirit comes out from the mattress and tries to run after her. She desperately calls the police as the spirit snatched her little brother. She runs after the spirit and ends up losing consciousness for a while. She finds Antonito in the bathroom, grabs him, and they all escape to safety. Veronica's mother notices cop cars passing by at the bar, and she couldn't help but worry about her children. She leaves the bar in the middle of the pouring rain and tries to get home. When Veronica and her siblings reach the exit of their building, she looks at a mirror and realizes that she isn't actually holding Antonito. It was all her imagination. With no choice, she comes back up alone to rescue her brother. The spirit strikes her and Veronica hits her head on a mirror. She is now holding a piece of broken glass as she finds Antonito hiding in a closet calling her name. Antonito refuses to come with her, making Veronica look at herself in the mirror, realizing that she has been possessed by the spirit the entire time and that she has been harming her siblings under its control. In an attempt to end the possession, she tries to slit her own throat, but the evil spirit manages to stop her. The authorities arrive at their apartment and are shocked to see Veronica being attacked by an invisible force until she passes out. This sight leaves them speechless. The paramedics rescue her along with Antonito. While the police observe the family's apartment, a picture of Veronica catches fire out of nowhere. At that exact moment, an officer calls the detective to inform him that Veronica has died. To this day, Veronica's story and death remain a mystery. Her story is based on a police report that happened in real life, and the police who have witnessed her case certifies it.